Hi guys, welcome back to Lunar Legend of Mana. Our little thing got bigger up here in the top thingy by my corner. It got bigger. Don't ask me how or why. I actually think it's the mana tree, but I'm not 100% sure. What's really sad, back when I first played this game, like many years ago. Oh, goodbye. Don't break down without me. Oh, trust me, you're coming back with me. Because the next area, guess what? We have no partner, so yeah, I'm bringing her. But back when I played this game for the very first time, I actually did have issues. Called. I did not do things right, because I literally placed everything where I wanted to place them, not where they need to go. I didn't follow any guide. I had no idea what I was doing. I was doing quests randomly. I think I printed off a walkthrough after a while, but as of right now, I don't know what all walkthroughs I printed off over the years, because I have walkthroughs I did not even know about. Example would be Dragon Warriors. I think it's Dragon Warriors before they came Dragon Quest. Oh, that was a weird scene. Let's give it to him. Just to see what it is. I got too many freaking long seats. But nonetheless. But yeah. Back on Game Boy Color, there was a game my mom got me, which was Dragon Warrior 3, which, yeah, I like. I had no problem with it. It was actually a good game. And there is a reason why I'm bringing her. I know you get more spirit points if it's just you and your pet, but she needs to come along. Okay, I'm gonna have her walk to here to save time. Let's see, the anchor is... Let's see, the rusty anchor is the harbor. The harbor goes above the white forest, which I don't have yet. Bottled spirit is the mind, which is technically what we need to drop. Cause that's where our next quest is. Boop. And since we got that down, oh, why can't I post that there? I'm supposed to post it there. Oh, shoot. I picked the wrong corner. Because the junkyard goes there. And I can't put it there. Oh, boy. Well, that one's going to be off. Oh well, it'll be fine. Book didn't tell me exactly where to pick, so it'll be fine. And so help me God, if I have to restart the game just because I picked the wrong corner, I'm going to be irritated. Because we're on quest 16, so we're not technically too far in the game. But still, I know my first pet would be a chocobo though. If I do restart, there won't be a rabbit. Just keep that in mind. Okay. Gimme. Russ. Okay, you can have it back. I don't need it. Oh, hello. You're weak. Never mind, you're not weak. Your jewels are very nice. Oh, let's speak all right. Room. I'm supposed to go up, apparently. To go into his workshop. Good day. I am whenever the... Wait. Yeah. The storyteller. The master is away. He's probably out mining deep in the dungeon. Mind your own business. Let me tell you of why it's... You're all whatever when he comes back. Okay. So yeah, now we gotta search for Wyatt. Which means we have to fight this thing again. Boom, boom, boom. Which is fine. Ammo bones. Okay. Go down. I was wondering when you were coming back. Wyatt leaves his shop a bit too often, I think. Thank you. Okay, there should be a save point around here somewhere. Da, 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 da. Boom. My chocobo is going to be so cool when he gets older. Or longer. I'm at a fork. Okay, bottom corner. Got it. Go down the stairs. And eventually we'll run into a save point. Keyword, eventually. Because that's how the game works. Oh, look, a save point. Is there a box nearby? Usually there's a save point. There's a box nearby. Ah, no, just multiple doors. Okay. Get back to the three hitters trying to take over the screen. I actually like how that effect is. Believe it or not, I actually like how that effect is. Okay, from the save point, we exit the... This one. If I grouped that, I can't technically hit. Oh, you know what? I know magic, so screw you. burn oil or yeah, I didn't. Thank you guys for heating it up for me. Acid. I question everything, but okay. Yay, I can hit things. I don't think I'm supposed to be able. Oh god. There's diamonds! I need those diamonds! You effer. You effer. I'm not even hitting the right button. Dragon bone. I question that, but okay. Doing. Doing. Okay. I don't even know who you are, but okay. I have no idea where I'm at. Or did I go in a circle? Those are the magical questions. And Kaspersky. Nothing was in the way. Boom. This place is a good area to grind to get money as well as spirit points. Cause I got a feeling this place is going to be a hell. Since the guy's not really helping. Although I'm pretty sure I went in a circle. Now I went straight to the boss. I'm busy, you. Come back later. Okay. You know there's a giant monster above you, right? Oh, never mind. I went the right way. I gotta talk to him 3 times. Stop it, you. Leave me be. I said cut it out. This place is dangerous. You best be on your way. You think the boss is like right above us? Okay. As you can tell, they each have their own health bars. And I'm just attacking the closest one. I'm staying over here. If I hit one, I hit one. If I don't, I don't. Okay. I'm glittering. Boom. Big chunks. And it died. Oh god, it's one of these. I'm glittering, so you can't hit me. Yay, Boko's alive. And she's alive. Means I can heal. dead again. You know, this boss is pretty easy. I'm glittering, you can't hit me. Boom! Choke, my chocobo's alive, why don't you go attack him? And leave me be. I only got 30 health. Die, die, die. Well, that was an easy boss. We're staying in the middle. Yay! What are you doing in a place like this? Mining is good here, but there is a famous monster about. Go home. I killed it. Already defeated it? You? You must be joking. Well, I did. Why, you're the I saw back in the dungeon. Yes. Well, who cares about that, right? Well, I'm busy right now, so go right back to your home. Ahem. Well then, now that he's here, allow me to tell you. Yeah, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, whoever persons wallets brilliant as he walks around. Oh, Wyatt, the small body underneath a giant thing. He spiked his hammer in his giant hat. Wyatt, our Wyatt, your soul is your great hat. Wyatt, Wyatt, our rocket. You haven't already done that much. Then... Shut up, you. I like the music box. Even though I can't technically hear it. Because the music of this game is so pretty, it puts you to sleep. No story to tell. Moon's mirror. Touch of coal. Thank you. Mind your own business. Okay. Oh, my tree's getting bigger. It says he only gives us the moon's mirror, but apparently we got more than just the moon's mirror. Okay, before we actually go home, let's see where these artifacts go. Let's see. Touch of coal. Coal. Whatever. That is the beach, and it go... Where does it go? Oh. Literally right there. Did it actually go in water? Huh, I already messed up. Because that one was supposed to go right here. Oh well. And I'm pretty sure that's supposed to go in water. Oh well. Okay. The beach. Next is the mirror. The mirror is power of whatever, which goes above another one. The anchor is, let's see, anchor, the harbor, which, I don't have White Forest. No, I think I'm right about this, because a ship goes there. And nothing's supposed to go here. One goes there. And two things are supposed to go here that they can't go. Sanctuary is supposed to go there. The Underworld is supposed to go there. White Forest, the harbor. Oh, I think I did screw up, guys. Because I can't put the broken doll down to get the junkyard. And I can't do Beedrill City because I don't think it can go in water. So I think before I can even do the next part to this, I'm going to have to literally restart and pick a different area, because it literally does not know how to pick anything. So here's the thing, it says, starting the game in the lower right corner of the map, nesting in mouth. See, I picked the same one. But, I don't know. And it literally said, keep an empty spot next to that first town, because that's where the mana sanctuary goes. Other than that, I don't know. Because I don't know why Junkyard can't go in that one area. Should be able to, but I may actually have to get the thing there to get there. I don't know, let me try. Oh, it goes now. No. Okay, this is where Junkyard goes. So apparently I did not mess up as far as I thought I did. Okay. Junkyard goes there. That actually starts the next set of lines. Now, Beedrill City, I guess it goes on water? Because apparently it does. Oh, I have another freaking line? Huh. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I'm not tripping. There's 4 lines. The 5th line is Beedrill, another city, a snowfield, and the tower. So, yeah. Okay, I'm done placing things. Now let's go home, talk to the vegetable. My tree's getting bigger. Okay, I don't actually need to restart the game. I thought I would have to. I'm sorry, guys. I actually did think I would have to start over, but apparently not. She's gonna leave. Oh, goodbye. I'm not gonna use her no more. I like it better with just me and my chocobo. We get better. We level up faster. And I think by the end of the game, I do want to be up pretty high. Because I've never gotten that far. You guys are going to see me beat a game I've never beaten before. And this is one of the oldest games I've ever played. Because, yeah, I'm playing the classic versions of Final Fantasy, but they're the remake. I'm not going to tackle any of the old games, because there's no way in hell I can. Now, the Dynasty Warrior, not Dynasty Warrior, the Dragon Warriors, or Dungeon Warriors, Dungeon Warriors 3 is what I remember. Now, that one I may do, due to the fact I actually like it. But I've never beaten that one. And it is so low freaking. It is so old. I could play it on the Bryzer. That's how old it is. Okay, the quest I'm going after is 17. It's Poco whatever Dream Teller. And the only way you can fail this one is if you leave the mines. So I can't leave. But this one doesn't seem like it's too difficult. Okay. We talked to him. Crypto does whatever. The Earth teaches us of chaos or cosmos and all of its ancient merit, whatever. When the grass squeaks and the stones sing, light streams on the earth. The light sprinkle in the feathers of the birds of paradise. The break loose from the sprinkles of time. Know what freedom is. The Dream Teller. Because I can't say your name. Who's there? I guess you're not that demon. I'm looking for Iwin. He's not only that demon's blood in him. His thoughts and actions, everything about him is demonized. I got to do something about it before it's too late. Oh, he's kinda cute. Eventually, he will bring whatever to this world. Whatever. You were such a fool. He tricked you into leaving the temple. Aw, he's kind of cute. But yeah, we're supposed to follow him. That's it. And still, the monster should be whipped. Thank you. Are you in a hurry? Yes. This way. I can't. Breathe. I see gas out here. It must be tough for you and him. I wonder if the main interest is still holding up. I don't know. Let's rest a little before we go further. Sulfur. Well, we haven't fought this one before. Boom, boom, boom. You have a huge health for a little monster. Why are you turning around? Stop hitting me! Die, die, die. Die, die, die. I really beat you. And you just give me bones, meat, and gloves. Okay, I have three ways to go. Where am I supposed to go? Leave right and go lower right. Okay, got it. You know what? I have... You can't hit me when I'm prickling, you frickin' effer. I am trying to actually do two quests in this one video. So, this video may actually be long. Yay, my chocobo went up a level. Probably because he gets higher. Freaking. Boom. Boom. They're plants. So... this should actually hurt them. No. I hurt them more. And they're just as annoying as they are in Final Fantasy. Maybe a bit more annoying. Die. Die, die, die. And I think Legend of Mana is sort of a Final Fantasy game. Believe it or not. Because it has two creatures of Final Fantasy. Its weapons are similar to Final Fantasy. So, I don't know. To me, it screams Final Fantasy. I don't know. Final Fantasy fans out there? Who know more about Final Fantasy than me? What do y'all think? Is this game a spin-off of Final Fantasy? Or something similar to Final Fantasy? You should... feel a little bit better here. Dot. I wonder why he hates you so much. Just because you are a demon? What happened? I hope that wasn't the entrance. That was the mind's entrance. I guess it was just too old. This was really fun at the beginning. It was the first time I've ever left the temple of my own will. But I can't take it no more. It's scaring me. You're protected by this spirit that also protected your insurance. If I die here, you will survive. I won't become the priestess. Because priestesses aren't allowed to be friends with demons. I'm not your friend. I just want to eat you up like all the demons do. You're lying. I want to go to the underworld. Adults are always telling us what to do. I don't like this darkness. Show me your spirit. It will tell us how to save ourselves. God. I don't want to go back. You got to live. If you hate this world so much, I will destroy it. We should have the freedom to use our power in any way we want. Yeah, okay. Your powers are mine now, spirit. Maria, you demon. What have you done to her? Save her? From what I could tell? I guess you retained consciousness, Celine. A right bird, Piper, does something. Whose side are you on? Are you with me, fighting for justice, or with her, aiding demons and making humankind your enemy? I can't decide. Because it literally says, if you choose her side, the kitty, he will attack you. If you choose his side, it doesn't say. I guess he doesn't attack you. I actually can't decide because I'm not with the kitty cat because she wants to save her best friend. So technically, she's with him regardless of the fact. And he just doesn't see it. So technically, I'm not choosing. So be it. Accept the path that you have chosen. And we have to fight him anyway. You, effer. I hate you. Die, oh god. Well, they said he's a wimp, so. Since he's a wimp, just, I don't know. When he flashes, get away from him. Literally. More like when he glitters, like I do. Oh god, he is a wimp. Okay, get away. You know, I can do glittering too. Pepper. Oh god, he is a wimp. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Getting away from you. Cause you suck. Chugabo, wake up. Help me. Although, he's not really hurting me. Yes, attack the Chugabo. It may be mean to me because I love chocobos and all, but it keeps me alive. That's all that matters. It keeps me alive. And it murders him faster. I'm glittering, which means boom. You suck. You know that you suck. This hits him faster. Oh god, you're glittering. I know it's technically flashing, but to me it's glitter. And you know what? The book's right. He is a wimp. He's easier than the other bosses. And he wasn't really a boss. I couldn't choose sides. The end. And he doesn't give us anything. Which freaking sucks. What was the point? It just tells you some of the storyline, which is good. And tells you actually some depth about three characters. But what I don't get is the kitty cat wants to save her only friend. Which that guy wants to do the same thing because he happens to be in love with the priestess. Or the knight of the priestess. I don't know. But he wants to save her and get revenge to that demon. Sadly, the demon wants, although he stated he's not her friend and wants to eat her up, he was her friend. Because he wanted to free her from her destiny, or her fate, whatever. He wanted to free her. He just didn't know what the hell he was doing. Because, again, they were children at the time. And, yeah. Because of that, I couldn't decide. Because the kitty cat and the knight are on the same side. So, I can't decide on that. And, yeah. I don't know if you choose his side if you have to fight him. You may not have to. Tell me in the comments section if you actually still have to fight him if you choose him. Because according to the book, if you choose the kitty cat side, you still fight him. I couldn't decide because they're both on the same side. And I had to fight him. So, someone please tell me if you still have to fight him even after you choose his side. Because something tells me, even though you choose him, you still have to fight him. But who knows, this is a children's game. That may not happen. And I'm getting too in-depth with this game. And I shouldn't be. Because now I'm questioning everything about this game that I didn't question about when I actually played this game. I mean, literally, when I first played this game, I was young. I was just getting into video games. I just got a PlayStation 1 at the time. I was playing Final Fantasy, this game, all at the same time. I wasn't truly paying attention. I was just playing for fun. So, there's a lot of quests I actually didn't do. Hell, Final Fantasy 7, which I was playing at the same time as this, I know for a fact I didn't do half the crap I should have done on Final Fantasy 7. Even when I beat it officially, I still didn't do anything, and I had to cheat just to beat it. And I don't mean game-breaking cheat, still the money cheat, which is the only true cheat I use. Only because I don't think it's right to grind your ass off for money. As the monsters get stronger, they should give you more money. On some games, they follow that formula, whatever. I have a speech impediment, so yeah. But on a lot of games, Sesame's early games, they don't. Even on the remakes of Final Fantasy 1 and 2, they don't. Now, 3 is not so bad, especially the remake of the DS copy. It's not so bad. I have not truly played the PSP remake, which I think is the same formula as the DS remake. I mean, Nuneth still falls through the hole and fights the goblin, so I'm pretty sure it's the same. And that one, you still have to grind your ass off to get money, but they make it more interesting. I'm still using the money cheat, because I hate grinding. I really, really do. This game, grinding is actually somewhat easy, because they throw you into quests that you can't do anything until you complete it. It means you can't leave that area. It means you have to go from area to area, fight all those monsters, just to do it. And with these different pets you can get, it actually makes it fun. Because you want to bring your pet up, and all these different characters you can have as teammates makes it fun. Because you get to play with different characters. Now, keep in mind, a lot of these characters do actually do things, but yeah. I should let you know something about this game later. I want to say after we do a certain quest, we actually get a weapon shop in our home. Literally. You remember the workshop I showed you back in one of the earlier parts of the Let's Play? That turns into a three-way shop at some point. Because I do remember that much of this game. Because I remember the giant tree and all the freaking seeds. I never actually got a chocobo. Even though I was playing Final Fantasy VIII at the time, I never got the chocobo. This is the first time I got a chocobo. This is why I worked my ass off to get a chocobo. I know, I just say, but I'm talking so freaking much. But anyway, guys, in that slide, and all this crap you actually don't need to hear, I'm rambling, I need to go to bed. So yeah, leave me a like, a comment, a subscribe if you haven't. Leave suggestions for the fifth pet I should already get. But keep in mind, four of my five pets that I'm able to have are taken. Because I'm keeping my bunny. I'm keeping my chocobo. I'm getting a dragon. I gotta pick which dragon I want. There's three types of dragons. So I gotta pick about that one. And I'm getting a succubus. Or, I don't know, a demon / human hybrid thing. Leave me alone. It's a human pet. I like human pets. But yeah, those four are going to be taken. What do you want my fifth pet that I probably won't really use unless I actually like that pet? Do you guys actually want me to get? You have until I actually beat the game to choose, because I'm not doing an extra video just to show off pets. Okay, I may. Depending. I probably won't. But yeah. And with that said, I will see you guys in the next video. So, ta-ta for now.